Well, Andrew, welcome to the mayor's office.
Thank
it's good to
having.
Have you here.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to, you know, explain a few things about the mayor's office. It's my understanding that this has been the mayor's office since 1898. They don't make them like this anymore.
Certainly not.
It's a real honor to be here and to have served here in this office for 16 years. I actually remember my first day sitting behind the desk. The office is so big. It's way bigger than the Oval Office. It's, I think, maybe three times as large as the as President's Oval Office in the White House. And so I'm sitting here. I remember calling my wife, Kim, a few times during the day, just said, "Hey, Kim, this is a big office." It's a big office. Well, of course, it's a big job. This has been a big honor. And I can't think of a job that's more rewarding, that's more fulfilling, that's more invigorating. I love this job. I still love this job. I love the people of St. Louis and the people I work with. But it's time. You know, mm-hmm. I've been in office now for 16 years. It's time to pass the torch. These paintings in here, and there's several that we'll talk about, this being one of them, were commissioned in 1902 when Rollo Wells was the mayor. And the paintings were done by an artist from New York named Frederick Stoddard. Mm-hmm. And you have here, I think, just a spectacular painting. The woman seated there represents the city of St. Louis. The past and present is represented by the tapestry on her lap. The past, has already been completed, as you can see, and the present she's still working on in the embroidery hoop. Yeah, you also notice that her arm is on some stones, and to the right, far right of the painting, you see 1764, which was the year that St. Louis was founded. You also have the fleur-de-lis here, the irises representing mm-hmm. France's presence, of course. If you look on the far left underneath the city seal, you see a teepee indicating Native Americans' presence here before the Europeans came and discovered St. Louis. And then in the background, you see the Eads Bridge. And I have here a key to the city of St. Louis from Henry Keel. I got this, I bought this from someone who bought it out of estate sale somewhere in Bon Terre, Missouri. But it's solid brass. I had it framed, and he was mayor from 1913 to 1925. If you go by days, he was the longest serving mayor before I was elected to a fourth term. I want to show you these paintings over here. Okay, you have same artist, same year, Frederick Stoddard, 1902. And he did a series of paintings that are representative of the Louisiana Purchase. On the far left here, you have Native American, of course, representing those that were here before the Europeans came. Then in the second panel, you have a young girl kneeling on the ground representing France. Mm-hmm. She's cultivating the irises or the fleur-de-lis. And then you have Spain represented by the woman in white who is actually watering the flowers. At the time, Spain was the true owner of the property. And then in this panel, you have France handing over the young girl, the Louisiana Territory, to the United States of America. And then here, this represents the westward expansion. This is a really interesting item. It is an original arch window.
Wow.
I got a letter from a gentleman back in 2013. He had a contract to change out all the arch windows. So he wanted to know if I wanted one. So he gave me this arch window. In fact, you know, he slid this little thing in the back to, you know, for effect,
right.
Make it look, you're like you're looking out the window, and the arch. But there are 32 of them. He had 32 of them, and he gave me this one. Each of them are numbered. This one's actually number one. This is a solid crystal, hand carved bat and ball.
Wow.
That was given to the city of St. Louis by Waterford and Macy's, and it was given in recognition of the city's the Cardinals' 2006 World Series win. Now it's very heavy, and I'll let you know hold it. They said it's not easily broken.
Yeah,
but it is. They said at the time that they gave it to me that it's worth $35,000.
Whoa!
This is a bust of Charles Lindbergh, and it was done in 1981. It was here, you know, when I took office. The relief that's here of the plane that he flew in, the Spirit of St. Louis, was done by the same artist and was given to the city of St. Louis in 2002 in celebration of the 75th anniversary of Charles Lindbergh's historic flight in May of 1927.
What are some of your more exciting memories of being in the office? What are some of the big days that you had here?
That's a long way to think. 16 years. You know, thinking 16 years, you know, what all the exciting things that happened in here, it's endless. Most recently, you know, I think a really big announcement was when we were able to secure, we were informed that the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency announced that they were they're going to build their new facility here in mm-hmm. North St. Louis, in the city of St. Louis. That was a big deal.
When you see the paintings in this room, it's the men who made these, it's obviously had big dreams about what St. Louis would be, and they're now 100 years old. Where do you see St. Louis being in 100 years? What do you see as some of its challenges and some of its successes, if you could predict the future?
Here's what I will say, is that if this city is going to really thrive and be relevant, you know, 100 years from now, there's several things that are going to have to happen. Number one, and most importantly, the city, there has to be a city-county reunification. There's no question about it. I see it every day. On a day-to-day basis, I see how that divide is holding this whole region back. This is a world economy now. We have to compete against the world. We can't compete against each other. And we're doing that too much every day. And I can give you a lot of examples. But I think, you know, children are really important in terms of where you need to focus your efforts. And crime, of course, are the two most important things, is making sure we have good opportunities for our children. We can have a good workforce, you know, so we can attract and retain good jobs here. And so young people have opportunities to reach their full potential, be good citizens, and contribute to the overall health and vitality of our city. We have to make sure that the federal government understands the importance of the Mississippi River. We have over 20 million people up and down the river that use this for drinking water. So for recreation, you know, environmentally, you know, there's a lot of what they call nitrogen loading. There's, you know, with chemicals from farming and that goes in the river. It causes hypoxia, which is dead zones, oxygen dead zones, kills everything. And so we need to make sure this river is clean, it's vibrant. It's a good place for commerce. It has the infrastructure necessary to handle the cargo that we're going to need. So those are all going to be really important to the future. But St. Louis, it has all the potential to be a much greater city as we go forward.